Urban regeneration as design, design as process. This was the topic that I gave initially to Ilaria to prepare her lecture. I already have a preview before. It's really interesting. You will be invested by a lot of pictures and I think a lot of suggestions. Don't be afraid. I'm telling that overall to the engineer, to the engineers and to the engineer side of the class. It's something to introduce you in a very good way, because I know that Ilaria can make this in a very good way, in the best way, to the topic of urban design.
Thank you to Marco Trisciuoglio and Alta Scuola Politecnica for the invitation. Thank you as a representative of the hedgehogs. I would like to start and thank you for the inspiring lecture by Marco Trisciuoglio, because some I think that on the background of my lecture we have the dialectic between design, project and problem solving, because decision making stays in the middle, I think, of these two cultures in this moment. And this could be interesting for the architects and the engineers and for the polytechnic culture, I think. So, I have to go. Okay. So, I try to start with the goal of this lecture. And by the background, I am an architect. I teach architectural design. So my point of view is architectural and human design. This is correct to be said. And I would like to start, and this would be boring maybe for the master students of architecture, and I apologize, but it's necessary, I think, for the engineers. By a topic which is a fundamental, architecture of the cities and cities in transformation is the topic with which we are dealing, particularly in Italy, but is the topic of the story of our discipline and of the practice of design, of architectural design. We will talk about the shape, so the shape in architecture, not in a very deep way in this case, but we will talk about morphology and typology. So the shape of the town, the shape of the space, connected with the shape of the buildings. Then we will speak a little bit about function and use. Why? Because we are speaking about, and you will speak about, an abandoned area. And so the problem of regeneration is also a lack of use, a lack of role of the areas of the town that are partially or completely abandoned, that are in a situation in general of decadence of their past use. And that could also enter in a situation of decadence of their physical spaces. And also about infrastructure, because also infrastructure is part of the infrastructure, is something that stays under the town and could and build the town. We will speak about time. Time and process and actors. I would like to say we have a problem about time. You face in different contexts of different types of times, and this is related, first of all, to the policies, In Italy, time of the transformation of the towns could be very slow. In China, could be very fast. To say something of that happens in the life of the cities and settlements nowadays. And so then we have a lot of terms that are connected with human regeneration nowadays. So we have modification, regeneration, recycle, but we have also other terms that I don't want to treat today that are rehabilitation, renewal, restoration, conservation, and so on. That means that the practice of design, of urban design, architectural design, has different type and don't know grade of transformation that we can imagine of our fabrics and towns and buildings and spaces that are related to different disciplines also, specialization and practices. And you know, because you are studying in a school of architecture, that that corresponds to, example given, different type of studios that you frequent if you are a student of architecture, a restoration studio, or a urban design studio, or a planning studio, and so on. So we are also speaking about different scales of the problems with which we have to deal when we design. And then I try to speak to you about some tools that we have, and so methodologies and strategies. So about strategies, because before Marco Trisciuoglio said something about that, and also showed a picture of a soldier. Strategy is a military term. There are some theoricians that treated this topic about Le Corbusier, and the use of the, all the words that are connected with military culture within the design culture. This is something that is very old and is connected also with the story of Polytechnic School, I think, starting from France, the military architecture. So this is interesting, it's something we can think about that. Example given in this period, someone says that maybe it's better to be tactical than strategic. It depends if you consider the practice of project with something of a hard, or as hardware, as a strong practice, or as a weak practice. And this is a problem of our time. Anyway, let's start about some ideas. I always start with this picture when I start with a course with my students. I have also a teaching in architectural design theory. It's a beautiful picture by Vittorio Carpaccio, the cycle of Sant'Orsola, it's in Venice, in Galleria dell'Accademia. And in my idea is interesting because it shows on the two parts of the picture, on the left part the medieval city and on the right part the city of Renaissance. And there is the flag signs the limit between the two type of idea of the relationship between town and architecture. Seems to be very radical. It's something that is connected with the idea that if you the idea of architecture is in the history of architecture strong connected with the idea of the town. So this is a sort of starting point, and this is for the engineers, this part. I think that we have to, is a short resume about that, about some fundamentals. The shape of the town is defined in some treatises of architecture and starts from the idea of the square. This is the Filarete treatise and the Palladio treatise of architecture. So, and those are some shapes that we recognize in our towns, that is the shape of the Acropoli and the shape of the Forum as sort of prototypes of the shape of public spaces of our squares in Western culture. And as we can see, as prominent part of the town, as the central and symbolic part of the towns. And so we have always to say that architectural design is an artistic practice. And so in the decision making, in a certain sense, there is another term that enters in a very strong way, which is creativity for an architecture, and maybe it's a shortcut, as Marco said before. But this is a sort of is another term that enter in our decision making in a certain sense, and we have also to say, and this is connected with the tools of architecture and of architectural and urban design, that for designing transformations we have to to give a judgment, we have to judge in a critical way. And this is one of the fundamentals of our work. Those are other images of the historical shape of our beautiful Italian towns, and also of some ideas that have a connection with the representation of the space of the Renaissance and of the Baroque, so with the image of the city. That is something of very important. And I think that it's important for us to fix a sort of background of our dialogue today. And also about what happens with the modernity, about those kind of lexicon of architecture. This is a sketch by Le Corbusier in a travel, his travel in Italy, about Pisa. We said before in the images of the Campo dei Miracoli, and this is a sketch of Le Corbusier. And then the design by Le Corbusier of the Chandigarh capital. Chandigarh is the capital of Punjab in India. It's a new town designed, completely designed by Le Corbusier. In this design, the idea is the idea of the Acropolis, so of a square in which we have a design of the level of the grounds, but architecture, the composition is done by prominent buildings that enter in a relationship one between another one. And with the landscape, with the Himalaya, this is not so clear in this image, maybe because of the lights, but anyway, on the back, there is the landscape of the mountains. And so here in this sketch of Le Corbusier, you can see the idea of the monuments and of the landscape. And so what is the idea of the center of the town? So you can see, starting from the first images of the Forum, of the Acropolis, of the old squares of our towns, what happened during the modernity about architecture and urban design. But now we are dealing about one of the most more important problem that we face, which kind of context for design? What is the city? The city is something that starts with the present, with a cross of street, with some fundamentals in the history of the town. It's a city that in history it is the plan of one of the African Roman cities by a text by Alberto Ferlinghe. And it's a description of a fabric that is mixed, not in fabric, but those ones are the Roman monuments, the theater. So we have the idea of a stratification, of a composition, of the importance of history in the way in which the towns are built up. And this is also in the European town, also some dynamic of the shape of the town, that is a sort of contraption that in some periods of the history we can face. The Roman town, you say it's a squared perimeter, is larger than the one of the medieval town in a certain period. So we have period of expansion and period of retraction of the town. And this is something, is a type of phenomenon that in a certain sense we have nowadays with, but in another way, because we have several and, how can I say, different dimension and shapes of abandoned areas within our towns and settlements. Abandoned areas and also infrastructures. So fabrics, the shape of the town, as those are beautiful photographs by Paolo Portoghesi about Rome. And it's something that shows the space of the square designed on the sky by the buildings. You can see in the plan of the town the same shape that you see done by the shape of the buildings. And also the dimension of the street in the ancient town in Rome. But we are dealing also with landscapes and different type of landscape. Cultivated landscape, as you can see, those are some photographs of Italian landscapes, but also landscape that are in a certain sense contaminated by infrastructures and by edges. We have always a situation, we find in all our towns in Europe, some situation of hybridation between agricultural spaces and recent dwellings outside the frame of the ancient walls. And those are conditions that we know very well in our cities that we cross when we are on a motorway or in a train. The problem is always that around our infrastructures and this kind of situation we have a very strong fragmentation and situation of marginality of some areas. And those are other phenomena that are related to our peripheries. When market streets, in a certain sense in Europe, began to become a problem. This is a study by Stefano Boeri of the end of the 80s, beginning of the 90s. in which the problem was to define the shapes and the names of the type of buildings that we find in our peripheries that are not, in the previous case we saw some industries, but those are all the commercial and service settlements that are now in our sprawled territories. And this is a view of Hong Kong, so just one to say what happens in some cities in the world. And so architects and designers and planners could face very different type of situation in during their work. And it's for that I think that the workshop that you are beginning now could be interesting both for architects and for engineers, because it's how to face complexity. And this is one of the main problems of our works nowadays. We were dealing this morning about that, about our course of studies. So, some step of our path as architect and urban designer. And this is something that is connected with the problem of tools of design and time. So urban project is a term that was defined in Europe at the end of the 80s, beginning of the 90s. And it's became a sort of paradigm of our way of working as architect during all the 90s and till the big crisis of the 2000, after the 2000. There are some experiences that are very important, that are real important steps. This is Berlin, and the experience of the IBA, so an experience of reconstructions. So the reconstruction of Berlin was still west, was not the actual political condition, was before the reunification of Germany. And there were a lot of unbuilt areas after the war that was destroyed after the war in the western part of Berlin. And so the IBA started with a strong program of reconstruction that was articulated in two parts. One part that was the old IBA that was related to the restoration of the old fabric. And another part, which was the new, this is the program of the old IBA. And another one that was the reconstruction of some neighborhoods, particularly about housing and dwellings, with the idea of reconstruct the fabric with the shape of the block, of the Berliner block. The tool was something very different from the urban planning of the 70s. The idea this is the period also in which the master plan became an important tool for architecture and urban design instead of the zoning. And so the idea is to define a master plan, and then, starting from the master plan, architects make the architectural design of each building. And so there is a problem of a design that could be achieved with an internal variety of the types and of the buildings. And also, in the case of IBA, but particularly about Barcellona, the topic was as soon as possible. So when Oriol Bohigas and the other planners decided to change the way of thinking of planning in Barcelona, was to define master plans and then also give commission to young architects with the component of risk, if we want to talk about decision making, for realizing in a very fast way the buildings that was possible to realize from the point of view of involved resources. So as soon as possible, with the idea of realizing a complete architectural and urban design. Also designed by parts and by variety of the architecture that was inside. It was a very big jump from the urbanism of the previous year that was completely based on zoning, of defining different functions and also gated functions within the expansion of the town. Those were areas of urban regeneration, if we can say, or rehabilitation, because there was the front of Barcelona that was occupied by railway tracks and industries, and the idea was this Olympic city that then was defined for Olympic Games, the idea to redefine the way of Barcelona to stay on the sea, to define a new waterfront. Barcelona hadn't a waterfront before. It was a city that was concentrated in the ancient town. So some events become a possibility of generation of new parts of the town. It was with the Olympic Games, but then in the history of our towns is a role played also by Expo exhibition, for example, in Shanghai, but also in Milan and in other towns, with some possibilities and some also weakness of what happened after the event. But in the case of Barcelona, the design was very well conceived, because it was not a gated design, was not a present, the one of the Olympic Games. And the goal was really to define a new fabric and a new infrastructural system for the town, with subways and railways and connections, and also a part of implantation that was connected as a sort of stronger infrastructure at the ground. So if you want to, make an evaluation today of the experience of Barcelona, we can say that it's very positive. Other experiences in Europe haven't the same type of good result. Those are other images of this situation. As fast as possible, those are areas of rehabilitation in the center of Barcelona. And those are some sketches of the possibilities of the images of a possible rehabilitation of the town that were made at this time. And then the project were very different. Example given, this one is the museum that now has been designed by Richard Mayer. So it's something of very different from this sketch. But the sketch gave an idea of the public space. So at the center of this idea was the idea of redefining a public space of the town. This one was one of the main topics. And so also the idea that the square, so the design of the ground, could make a rehabilitation of a neighborhood in which the facade was something but not so interesting. So intervention on the public open spaces as a tool. The idea of redesigning the relationship between the fabrics and the part of the town, and also using squares as a place that cover infrastructure, parkings or subways, or this is the station of a subway, so the idea to redesign the road, or using abandoned spaces to design parks in the edge of the town, so spaces for people. And the idea also the relationship with the practice of arts, with sculpture that had to be put inside the town. So those are other. And this is another important experience of the same years, but done in a different way. This is Amsterdam and the docks of Amsterdam. So this is connected with an abandoned infrastructural area of the port. Those are the docks as they were. An important part, very artificial, as is in the Netherlands, the ground, the connection with the water. And those are the master plans. So you see always this tool of the master plan that enter in the reorganization of the town. The idea of working with models, with the volume of the city. Those are the buildings that have been realized by prominent architects. They did some competition, but also calls, direct calls to the architect to build up the new street, with the idea of reconstruct, also an idea of a traditional town, for in a certain sense. This is a building by Koloff, very, very interesting. This is another part in which they worked with the low-rise fabric. And this is enough interesting because it speaks about the actors. Here we have the scheme of the clients and the developers of the project and the number of involved architects on the other side. And the type of dwelling types and public spaces. Those are the models. And as you can see, all this from this photograph that is recent, all these designs have been realized. This is something that now is not so easy to realize. We need more time because of the crisis, so we have to be more tactic in a certain sense. In other countries, in China, as we say, they are very fast in building up expansion of the cities with some environmental problems in this moment. So it's a complicated balancing of our activities. So we need some tools. We need some tools to, in this period, to make judgments. This is our problem. And I show you some results of some researches. The first one is a commitment by the municipality of Milan of the 2006 is a description of the fabric of Milan. The commitment is related to define a background for a plan of the rules, as is the name of the tool, of the planning tool. and so to become the background of a decision-making system from the point of view of the planning. And I show it to you because it's something that is enough clear to define in a town which parts are strong and which parts are weak from the point of view of the shape. And so from the point of view of the possibility of transformation of these areas, this was the question that the public administration asked me. And so I tried to define several layers of the shape of the town. And then the public administration defined different rules of transformation of the parts, in depending if they are strong, and so they have to be preserved, for example, or they are weak, and so in those parts the administration think to apply some strategies of transformation with master plans and so on. This is a first part that is very general and talk about the shape of the land. This is a radial shape done by streets and some prominent areas. And the system of the big parks of Milan. This, I have to say that those readings are partial because are devoted just to the perimeter of the of Milan as town. Where these readings don't speak about the metropolitan area because the commitment was by the municipality. But anyway, I tried to do that, and this is the part that is more interesting in my idea because it's the one which tried to give a definition of the weaker part of the town. The part that have some buildings or spaces that were in a process of decadence from the point of view of the users, but also from the physical point of view. And it's a very huge part of Milan, in fact, of different type of with different type of problems. And so we tried to to classify the different type of fabrics, to define different type of rules. I don't want to be long about that because it was a very important work, also based with on GAS system. So every building, every block had on the back some information on the informatic system of the municipality of Milan about the property, the function, the condition, etc., etc. And this is a park in which we went in deep about the part of weakness of some fabrics. The gray areas were the more solid in a certain sense, and the colored one defined a different type of weakness of the fabric. And then this is the plan, the zoning that the municipality of Milan applied after the drawing, the description that I did. This is just one of the tables, and then there is a document and rules and so on. So a complex system of plans and documents. So a description could be the starting point for a policy, for a urban planning policy definition, but also more recently, in 2008, we start to do a research in our research lab about the problem of regeneration of some neighbors on the western part of Milan. And here we did some description another time with was an academic research, so we were more free in a certain sense to define methodologies. And we considered also something that was outside the border of the administrative borders of Milan, so talking about the metropolitan area, because in fact we were working on this part of the town, this one, that is an in-between the main part of Milan and the metropolitan area, which is very inhabited. And so we are in the middle of a wider, of a huge settlement that is the metropolitan area in the direction of Torino. This is the way, the west part of Milan. And so we tried to do to read the different layers of the shape of the town, also in this situation, trying also to find the settlements that were related to the agricultural shape of the town. Because in fact, in this area, we are in a situation of hybridization between the expansion of the town and something that were before, under the town. So the agricultural part, which is in a certain sense mixed and survive near the town, which is a resource, it's a richness for our towns, has to be considered as a richness for us. So those are some readings, and I would like to show you, because I think that you will have to, I know that you will have to do some diagrams. And so we arrived to define some strategic diagrams that are parts that the designs in during the time of the development that we know that it's not possible that nowadays is all at the same time, is the basis for designing parts of the town. And so we considered several parts of the town, and as the system of the water, something that is very important, as we know in Italy now, in designing towns. We have a big problem in Rome now with water. And so we have to consider that we have a landscape of water that we have to preserve and to put attention to this type of landscape. I go fast. So we tried to discover the different layers of the town. And this is a sort of starting point for a diagram. We put in a relationship some neighbors of the 60s and even before of the 30s. This is the neighborhood of San Siro, which has a lot of problems. It is a neighborhood of the 30s, which is in of popular housing, which is in a strong decadence. This one is the Galaratese, in which you have the building of Aldo Rossi and Carlo Morino, which is very well known as the QT8 neighborhood. This is an interesting modern part of Milan. And other sprawled neighborhoods that have a shape anyway, that they have some condition of decadence and they need intervention of regeneration because the dwellings are old, have to be restored or renewed, or in part we have the idea that something could be demolished to keep space, for example, or to put inside new buildings that could define a better way of life as services in this type of neighborhood. Because regeneration, I think that also the speech of the next day will talk about that, is a problem also of social regeneration, especially in this period in which we have a mixed population that composed the inhabitants, especially of the peripheral neighborhoods. In Milan now we have the administration now launched a strong project about the regeneration of peripheries. It's one of the main topics that concern our town in the next 2 or 3 or 4 years. Talking about urban quality in this kind of context is also talking about the quality of open spaces that are both parks, those are parks that are designed, or sports settlements, but also agricultural residual areas, the green one, but also roads and squares that are fragmented but could be involved in a design which is not probably a so defined design as the one of Barcelona, but it's the possibility to recognize those spaces as part of a chain of spaces that could be improved during the years. So probably taking more time, taking 10 years to define a final design that could also accept some variation inside. This is the sense of a strategic drawing, the idea to have the possibility of accept different design and changes during the years and not to define all in the first time and to do this as soon as possible, as the case of Barcelona. So those are some studies about the relationship between spaces in those neighborhoods that are very dense, as the first case is the one of San Siro, which is a very dense and very complicated neighborhood. We have some images about that. This is the situation, actual situation of the buildings. Streets are very are defined by fences. There are parts that you cannot cross. And so there is also a problem of security. Security is one of the main problems that we face in our periphery. And the design of in-between spaces, of public spaces, is something that could give security to our neighborhoods. So this was a design done by some PhD students about the hypothesis of working on public spaces and also to demolish some parts of these neighborhoods and build up some other one with services and give another type of shape to this neighborhood. And this is a way of defining categories of interventions by layers. So, how to design public spaces, how to design, in this part, how to design streets, how to design the built-up spaces inside a settlement. And this is a first strategic sketch about that. It's a sketch that speaks about new type of connection between parts that were completely divided. Those connections could be done also with slow mobility. Parts for bikes and so on, of reorganizing the public transportation service. This is something of very interesting. Reorganizing the space of the street. Our towns are full of cars that have no place to stay. The idea is to have parkings to use the open space as a new connecting space. Which was the idea of this project? That you have the center of the town, that is something that has a dimension. This is Piazza del Duomo. In the metropolitan area, we have a new dimension of the problem of the public space. And so, probably, the public space of our town is not the space of the old square, but is defining the space of the relationship between the existing spaces as the resources. And so the problem of the shape is something of different from the slides that you see at the beginning of the lecture. It's not a problem maybe to define a square as St. Peter's Square. We have another type of goal in our actions. And also to define spaces and situation all around the infrastructure, because we have a problem with the infrastructure that they became a sort of boundary within the metropolitan territories. And so maybe we have to find places in which define how to cross the infrastructure. In some situation is possible because you have bridges, in other not, and so this is a problem also. And so one topic is how to evaluate the degree of transformability of the urban fabrics in the time. This is one of the problems of regeneration, which is connected with several problems that a policy have to face, social problems, economical problems, and so on. So we started working this research about streets and open spaces. This is the starting point for us within the fabric of some of those neighbors that have to be regenerated. We have the neighbors of the 30s, 40s, and 50s in this part of the town, but also some ancient settlements that was connected once a time with agricultural landscape that survived with other more recent settlements. In some of those parts we have the abandoned areas by industrial activities that doesn't work, and so they could become part of this regeneration project. So here there are some possible paths and the relationship. This is a strategic diagram. This is something that speaks about the type of landscape that we have in this area, which is something of very different in the different parts. As you can see, we have part of countryside, but also recent buildings for offices that are in some crisis also. Most of all are abandoned also, because they built up in Milan during the 70s and the 80s a lot of buildings for offices that have not been used as they imagine about as cube of buildings. And those are the situations that we can find in this part of the edge of the town. Those are some views of those neighbors that need a restoration. This is the Lorenteggio neighborhoods. And those are some strategies about the neighborhood, in which we treated about the consistency of this neighborhood and the condition of the open spaces. And also we did some comparison with the density of the historical part of the town to have an idea of the dimension of the street, also of the sense of urbanity that this kind of neighbors need, in fact. So some dimensions are compared. Then we read some phenomena. Those are the dwellings, and those are some phenomena of not allowed occupancy of the buildings, which is something but very strong in this part. Those are technical parts, those are services, but they are not so much in the neighborhood. Then we tried to read also the private space, open private space, and public space, that now are completely separate because of the presence of the fencing, as you can see. And there is no care of the spaces, because care of open public space is something that costs, in fact. And so we tried to work on the ground floor and on accessibility. So one of the goals is to demolish fencing, to open paths, to try the way of maintain public spaces. In this sense, we did this work as architect. It's obvious that then the need is the need of policies that could maintain, from the point of view of money, these spaces. So, an interdisciplinary work is absolutely necessary in this case, in this type of design research. And those were different strategies about how to redefine the spaces. And also we studied something about sustainability, and so because we decided to demolish something to give more sun. And so it's a study of the sun and also of the wind, because of the quality of the air. We are facing a problem of climate change in all our towns, so we need as designers some tools to face this kind of problem. And so we tried to do that. Those are the study of the shadowing of this of those spaces during the different seasons. So then we studied typologies. One of the problems is also how to renew typologies. Sometimes typologies are too small or too big. And this is one of the problems. We have to face the problem of new type of work. There is a lot of people that work at home, and so this is a possibility. There is also, when we talk about industry 4.0, to imagine new shape of production that could enter in the shape of the neighborhoods in a different way and in an interesting way. So this was the possibility of demolish some parts and adding some small buildings devoted to common services related to each court. The idea to sprawl the services places, and also with the idea that the inhabitants could organize some activities, I don't know, to take care of the children or of the aged people within the neighborhood. And so this is the relationship between the renewed buildings, the blue one, and the new buildings that we put inside. So a selected way to propose a regeneration of this level. And this was an hypothesis of how to build this, to make this operation of regeneration during the time in several phases. We defined 9 phases of how to design the different parts, how to complete each part, and to don't to try a way to do that. Those are some ideas of the project. And those are diagrams of the design actions that we imagine to do about the buildings. So the time of example given, demolition of the stairs, building, how to build an external stair, then how to define the new distribution inside the building, and so on. And then how to demolish and how to reuse and recycle the parts that we demolished within the neighborhood. How to build a higher part on the building. How to work on the ground floor. In those neighborhoods, one of the more important work in our idea is the one on the ground floor and on the first floor, on the basement of the building, because this is the quality of the common space that changed. And also is the idea of devoting spaces for working and for the community at the ground floor. This is a work on street, on the connection and on the parkings, as element of quality of the neighborhood, with some ideas that are a little more strong, not so tactic, but a little more important. Those are parts of the operation of rehabilitation, example given to define an entrance to a park. Now we have several parks in this area which have not services or parking area at the entrance. It's impossible to say here is a park. It's just a sign, Parco delle Cave. But there is nothing as devices, I don't know, a place in which you can put the car and take a bike or drink coffee, nothing. And so those are hypotheses of how to define some other parts of this part of the town, western part of the town. It was a very huge project. This is a part related to a cascina, which is an old settlement, and how to define an area of a public park all around. This is another study about other diagrams. Quanto ancora? Finito praticamente. Fino a quando è andato? Vado? Could become boring, so I go faster. This is a very huge neighborhood in Rome, a neighborhood built up during the 80s. And which has a very difficult social situation, is one of the problems of Rome. And so one of the past administration gave a to level clear the commitment of a new neighborhood with the idea of demolish the one of the 80s, which is this one, and build up a low-rise, low-density neighborhood, which occupy a lot of ground more. The other part that you see represented at this, with this texture is something that arrived to the town by an out-of-law way of building of the town, which is something of very frequent in some towns in Italy, in Rome particularly. And so those are two readings that we did, two synthetic readings. And the sense was that the neighborhood of Robert Krier seemed a lot to the part of the town that was all around. Anyway, we tried to say maybe it's not necessary to demolish Tor Bella Monaca. We can think about making an operation of rehabilitation. This is not very simple because of the type of system of construction that was a heavy prefabrication system, was done with a tunnel system. I don't know if you know what it is. Was a system in which houses were built, I try to simplify, with elements that were as tunnel over a mountain in a building. So very rigid and very difficult because all is was in concrete. And those are some schemes that we did. One of the problems of Tor Bella Monaca is that if you are an inhabitant of this part and the school is there, for example, given, you have to take a bus and it's very far away and you have to do, I don't know, 3 or 4 stops of bus. So there is a problem of distances because the dimension was very huge. It's a neighborhood that has a strong resource, which is the shape of the landscape that is very beautiful, is the landscape of the outside of Rome. And this was a value for us, the value of open spaces. And so we worked about a new and faster system of transversal connection and longitudinal connection from the point of view of transportation. And those are some diagrams related to, in the same place where we put the housing, where the schools, where situation connected with the landscape and so on. This is a layering system, as the previous one. This is modern. This is another study about the sun and the sustainability of the buildings. And then there are some actions of regeneration in which we decided how has to be done in the buildings. If there is something to add or to damage or to renew inside each one of the buildings. And we worked on the ground floor another time. And also adding some parts to redefine the typologies of the houses. In a certain sense, the buildings of Tor Bella Monaca, because of the system of the tunnel, were all organized on an horizontal system in a certain sense. We tried to connect the ground floor and open some vertical apartments as a duplex, with a duplex system in which we joined spaces for work and spaces for live. and so trying to put more variety inside buildings that are very boring from a certain point of view, from a typological point of view. And to define more permeability at the level of the ground, because this was another problem, and redesign the spaces of the courts as public spaces really used by the inhabitants. So this is the new way of defining the types in duplex and to redefine some parts. This is another research that we did about with a huge group in Italy. The name is Recycle Italy, in which we did an important atlas of, on one hand, abandoned area and typologies of abandoned areas, and also an atlas of design strategies related to an idea to give a new life cycle to some buildings or areas at different scales, how to give a new life. So this is something I think also of a little bit different as idea from the idea of human regeneration, because involved also materials and different scales of the problem. This is some images of this atlas that we did about the northern part of Italy. It's work that we did with the colleagues of Politecnico di Torino, particularly. There are also other areas related to the sea, as you can see. And this is something of interesting of this atlas that is related to infrastructure, as I said before. There are a lot of small railway networks that could be used to, that are mostly in part abandoned, but in part underused in a certain sense, with trains that are no good, the bad connection. So the idea is to redefine connection and reuse and make operation of rehabilitation of these small networks, because Italy worked a lot on high-speed connection, but in a very bad way on the local connection. And so also for give a new life cycle to some parts of Italy that are in a state of decadence, particularly the parts that are related with the Appennino. Now the problem is every day more important with the earthquake areas, but there are some phenomena that several years that happens that from the Appennino, the population moved in the direction of the coast, of the coastal areas. And so there are some problem of abandoned area in all this part. And so we tried to define a new role for this more connection and infrastructure. So we are talking about some tactical strategies in this case, some punctual strategies of design and recycle and regeneration. And so we did a similar work about the road system. And those are the areas in which we worked with some proposal of recycling strategies. This is an atlas, and this is one of the areas that we chose with the research unity of Politecnico di Milano near Bergamo. Is an area that is characterized by a railway, by a local railway, the Ferrovia delle Valli, that has been utilized. Renewed recently by by the public administration, and it was a valley in which there were a lot of industrial settlements that are now abandoned, and that the research tried to reuse and redefine. So those are some readings, and another time some strategies. This is the part of the railway system that arrives in Bergamo. And some diagrams about these infrastructural systems, and then some strategies that regard some industrial buildings that could be improved and reused with the light bed strategies. And also in this case, we have defined two phases: one potential and one more radical from the point of view of transformation, so an evaluation of the degree of possible transformation connected to the availability of resources. And this is something, a similar research done with an international research group on the edges between the Netherlands and Germany, IBA-Parkstadt, inside the framework of IBA-Parkstadt. And this is are some diagrams about strategy of new connection of slow mobility within this area. As you can see, you have the scheme of the paths for car, for paths for bikes in the Netherlands. It's very important in an area which is not so, it has not well-defined connections, and some hypotheses of how to reuse some agricultural buildings in a new touristic network. This was the hypothesis. So the pubs are related to that, to this kind of reuse. This was the area of an old small airport, which is still active, and some settlements around the airport. This was the workshop about that. So this is a design at the scale of the landscape. This is a doctoral thesis about a problem of the recycle of an industrial area in the metropolitan area of Paris, in Aubervilliers. And this is interesting because it's an area that has a sort of process of double time of abandoned area. And so this is the type of very fragmented fabric and some schemes of possible actions of regeneration of this area with new settlements. And those are experiments in China, something that Marco Trisciuoglio very well known. This is near Shanghai, is a water town. There are several of these settlements that are involved in a so strong and huge development, urban development as the one of Shanghai. And the problem here is to preserve some part. Preservation is a sort of is an important topic nowadays for China. They ask more and more to preserve buildings and parts of their towns. And also in this situation, we worked with the PhD students on how to build up a new relationship and how to manage the water and the public spaces of this label. This was a very fast workshop, and in this case, the PhD students make a choice about the buildings that have to be preserved and put them in a network as a point of regeneration of all the town all around. And they define some urban sections and types that have to be preserved. And some intervention about the typologies, how to renew them or also to rebuild them with some prototypes in a certain sense. Also putting some new intervention within the old one. In a very light way and also in an economic way. So this is the idea of how to interpret it, the type of shape of this low-rise settlement and water settlement. Those are the new buildings and the old one in a comparison, in a possible comparison. So it's a sort of image of this part of the town.